117, Ashes. We rise again from ashes, from our good we failed to do. We rise again from ashes to redeem our Lord by you. Our end is the Lord, our sorrow.
Today we have a memorial for St. Tiburtius of Mongerhaven. He was born in Spain as a professor of law and later counselor and acting president in Granada. Appointed as a layman to be Archbishop of Lima, Peru. When he arrived in Peru, he was appalled by the European conquerors who exploited and oppressed the native people. He condemned the abuses found in schools, hospitals, and churches. May we imitate his love and service for the poor. He was also, again at the same time, St. Martin de Porres and St. Rose of Lima lived in Lima and were ministering, and he inspired them, and they inspired him. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, in order to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we first call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, upon yourself you bore the guilt and sin of us all. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you came not to be served, but to serve and give your life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, the will of the Father is accomplished through you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins. Bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Today's reading focuses on the commandments of God.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to the people and said, Now Israel, hear the statutes and decrees which I am teaching you to observe, that you may live and may enter in and take possession of the land which the Lord, the God of your fathers, is giving you. Therefore, I teach you the statutes and decrees as the Lord, my God, has commanded me, that you may observe them in the land you are entering to occupy. Observe them carefully, for thus will you give evidence of your wisdom and intelligence to the nations, who will hear of all these statutes and say, This great nation is truly a wise and intelligent people. For what great nation is there that has God so close to it as the Lord our God is to us whenever we call upon him? Or what great nation has statutes and decrees that are just as this whole law which I am setting before you today? However, take care and be earnestly on your guard, not to forget the things which your own eyes have seen, nor let them slip from your memory as long as you live. But teach them to your children and to your children's children. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response, praise the Lord. Glorify the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion. For he has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. He sends forth his command to the earth. Swiftly runs his word. He spreads snow like wool. Frost he strews like ashes. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. He has proclaimed his word to Jacob, his statutes and his ordinances to Israel. He has not done thus for any other nation. His ordinances he has not made known to them. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Your words, O Lord, are spirit and life. You are the words of everlasting life.
Praise to you.
Amen, I say to you, until heaven and earth pass away, not the smallest letter of the law, not the smallest part of the letter will pass from the law until all these things have taken place. Therefore, whoever breaks one of these least of these commandments or teaches others to do so will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. Whoever obeys and teaches these commandments will be called greatest in the kingdom of heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have various states of life, and you know, these readings talk about them, you know, being a disciple, being a parent, being a grandparent, you know, being part of the people of God. And and we have a responsibility, it seems to be saying, that we've got this great law, we've got these great teachings, we've got these commandments that are good things, you know, that we're proud of them, we live by them, they mean a lot to us. And, you know, again, we have the torch, we're the torch bearers, we pass it on. Talks at the end, of course, about children and your children's children, teach them. And so we keep doing this, and we keep trying to do this. It seems like, you know, it's something we have to acquire. It seems like Jesus is pointing at us that, okay, there's the laws, there's the regulations, but somehow you get through them and they give you meaning in life, or it's a relationship with God, a relationship with Jesus that gives you meaning and purpose and life. Once you find that, then the things fall in place. Then it says, right, keep the laws. You know, don't lead anybody astray. You know, be a good example, because you found that freedom. Now you have to be an example to others. And it says, you know, what nation has ever seen that the God is so close to us, the Lord our God, whenever we call upon him? So we pray today then to take care, Lord, to give us the responsibility, give the ability, give us the grace, give us the Holy Spirit to share your ways, your commands and teachings that do have meaning and life. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Statutes and teachings that bring life with the world that needs so much of God's help, we offer our prayers.
Our response will be, Holy Spirit, lead us. That God may bless our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and all church with conviction in following the stirrings of the Holy Spirit, we pray.
Holy Spirit, lead us.
For leaders of nations, that they may seek diplomatic solutions to conflict and war, we pray.
Holy Spirit, lead us.
For peace, that God will bring an end to violence in Ukraine, protect the innocent from harm, and open channels for food and medicine, and help peace negotiations to begin, we pray.
Holy Spirit, lead us.
For refugees from Ukraine, that God will guide them to places of safety, help them to find welcome and new homes, and open the hearts of many to provide the resources that they need, we pray.
Holy Spirit, lead us.
For the members of St. Mark and St. James, that we will be led by the Spirit this Lenten season, we pray.
Holy Spirit, lead us.
For our second graders and their families, that after their first reconciliation, they may experience the transforming power of God's love and his tender mercy, we pray.
Holy Spirit, lead us.
That those who have died in the light of Christ, especially Bishop Donald Troutman, that they may come to join God and all the angels and saints in heaven, we pray.
Holy Spirit, lead us.
For any special intention you may wish to voice. We pray.
Holy Spirit, lead us.
O God, who gave increase to your church through the apostolic labors and zeal for truth of the Bishop St. Turibius, grant that the people consecrated to you may always receive new growth in faith and holiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. of human hands and become our spiritual drink.
This blessing of our prayer.
May my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Thanksgiving, this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, that we are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ. And make of us an eternal offering to you. We may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with all of the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, Lawrence, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all clergy, entire people you gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family you have summoned before you. In your mercy, O Father, compassion, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Bishop Donald Troutman, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that he was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. To our departed brothers and sisters, all who are pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, your kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Christ, our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Thank you.
have been fed. Sanctify us, O Lord, cleansing us of all errors. Make us worthy of your promises from on high, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. So, today, Lenten luncheon at 12:05, Stations of the Cross at 5:30, Holy Hour and Confessions at 6 o'clock. There we go. Okay, so Friday's the act of consecration of Russia and Ukraine to Our Lady, the Blessed Mother. And so, the bishop will have, I'll go on Friday. First of all, if you want to stay home and watch a live stream of the bishop after the 6:30 Mass, there will be the consecration for our diocesan consecration in union with the Pope. Okay, so, and you can check the Diocese of Erie web page for that link. Here at 8 o'clock on Friday, we will have then a rosary, special rosary, then we'll have the act of consecration, and we'll have a communion service. That's Friday at 8 o'clock here. 12 noon, the Pope will be on EWTN, be in the Vatican, and that will be, again, broadcast through EWTN at 12 noon on Friday, again, the act of consecration of Ukraine and Russia to Our Blessed Mother. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
God's blessing upon you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorify the Lord by your life.
Amen. Amen.